And my brother Joe took off in my Ford from San Pedro. We hadn't much gas and the tires were low, but the doggone Ford could really go. Now along about the middle of the night, we were ripping along like white folks might. When a murky behind, he blinked his lights, he honked his horn and he flew out of sight. We had twin pots in the Columbia, but you people may think that I'm in a rut, but to you folks who don't dig the jive, that's two carburetors and an overdrive. We made grease spots out of many good town and left the cops' heads spinning around and around. They wouldn't chase, they'd run and hide, but me and that Mercury stayed side by side. Now we were Ford men and we likely knew that we would race until something blew, and we thought it over, now wouldn't you? I looked down at my lovely bride, her face was blue, I thought she had died. We left streaks through towns about 40 feet wide, but me and that Mercury stayed side by side. Was pale, he said he was sick, he said he was just a nervous wreck, but why should I worry, for what the heck, me and that Mercury was still neck and neck. Now on through the deserts we did glide, a flying low and a flying wide, me and that Mercury was taking a ride, and we stayed exactly side by side. In my mirror and I saw something coming. I thought it was a plane, but the way it was a running, it was a humming along at a terrible pace, and I knew right then it was the end of the race. When it flew by us, I turned the other way. The guy in the Mercury had nothing to say, for it was a kid in a hopped up Model A.